Hello, so we'll be doing all of the Joker's secret interactions. Now, these are unique rewards that you will never be able to get just by playing the game or by chance. So let's go. The first interaction is when you first see the Joker in the basement on top of the bomb pile. By the way, pressing and holding G brings up the emote wheel. Wait until he starts juggling. Come on, juggle. And then... clap. We got 750 scrap because we already have the Joker bell, or the Jester bell, Jester card, which is pretty easy to recognize. It just looks like a funny card. And then you also have to get the mask because that will be needed for our step. Now I already got the rewards, so I pretty much know how to do this. If the cards you want are not in his jaw, sometimes they'll not be there. That means you'll have to die and come here again. Don't worry, you just have to climb the elevator. Sorry about the effects, the game had an update, so look. Okay, that's the one-eyed jester. It's actually easier to get the other cars because they don't spin around as much. Wait, was that? If that's not the interaction you're after, you can just go out. Now, the Jester one is pretty easy to see because you'll just get an item from a chest. Yeah, that was the right one. And you'll get, of course, the one-eyed Jester. Or the one-eyed Joker. So, I don't know, it's easy to confuse them because one is a Joker and the other one is a Jester. Let me show you what I mean by that. Where is the other one? Yeah, the Jester Bell and the One-Eyed Joker Idol. This is one of the more unique cards because you can basically do it in boss fights and just do a neutral dash and then get 25% extra crit chance for Oh, look at that, that's the devil. On the bright side, it's very easy to know if you are in the right room because you'll have a little corrupted boss fight. Yeah, this is it. Vortex! Okay, this is on the easiest difficulty. It can be annoying because he's...
That's it.
Yeah, I guess you can also farm this encounter for a corrupt Illuminate. You get a Misfortune Melee Mutator, which is not so interesting because it doesn't really do much. It increases melee damage by 5% for each unique. I mean, probably if you upgrade it, and if you have a lot of status effects on the enemy, by the way, at level 10 it will also apply slow, which is a negative effect. And it's not the best, it's just there. Now, get the mask, finish the event, get the mask, and we'll see. Here we just insert the masks. But also switch it to the other side. The general rule is that you have to have the golden side next to the door. Now we just have to head back to the locations where we first saw the Joker. So as you can see, this is the area you first came out of Iron Brow. And as you can see, we have the Catalogger Jewel over here. It's a nice drink, some people like it, I don't like it very much because it doesn't do anything particularly well. Just hard to find in your inventory. any second. Here it is. Just generates 8 mod power per second automatically, which you might think is great, but imagine in 10 seconds you get 80. And Archon generates only 3 per second, so you get, let's say, 80 per 10 seconds, so in 30 seconds you might get enough to fire a mod. And it might be helpful in the long run, but... The Simulacrum appeared over here, and we're down where we first saw the Joker. So you have to switch that around and then switch it back, and then you'll get the Simulacrum down here, and also the Shahed Bloom Crystal. Which again is arguably one of the best amulets if you're lazy, if you don't have a build. It's just a flat 30% damage bonus. But then it switches between physical and elemental. Now, if you're doing a lot of elemental damage like fire or other stuff, I guess that could be also good, so I guess it's the best amulet for lazy, non-build oriented.